We're talking about a serious subject. In fact, it's a world epidemic, and that is insufficient sleep. So what do we need to do if we are time poor, stress rich, and many of us are decision fatigued? There's so much coming at us. Exponentially, we're having to change stuff in our life and rejig and repivot. So we forget about sleep. Sleep seems to be a luxury. It's something that we'll do when we're dead or we are up all night replying to emails, trying to get on top of life. And it's practically impossible to do that if you don't rejuvenate your brain. So here's the deal. You need minimum 7 hours a night, maximum 9. Find your sweet spot between those two. But more importantly, you need quality sleep. So what do we mean by that? We need absolutely to have 4 stages of sleep. So stage 3 and stage 4 is your deep rejuvenating sleep, where we get rid of toxins in our brain, because this nut does not go to sleep. It actually works while we have got head on pillow. So stage 3 and stage 4 sleep gets rid of the toxin called beta amyloid. That is the plaque between your neurons. So if you're going to get stage 3 and stage 4 sleep, what's going to happen is in the morning, you wake up completely refreshed. So what we want is we want to wake up before our alarm goes off. We want to wake up feeling vibrant, not with a disheveled feeling, the alarm's going off, what do I need to do, where am I, who am I? So I'm really hoping that we start to take cognizance of sleep being the Swiss Army knife of our health, and most importantly, start to look at the fact that that affects how we eat, how we exercise, and of course how we manage self-compassion, and how we interrelate with others. So please speak to us some more if you really want to get into the depths of what you can change and what you could do differently.